All right, well, happy Wednesday. Welcome back to the channel. Today we're doing something that's constantly overlooked in the fluid department as far as changing on a car, and that is your power steering fluid. If you follow the channel, I did my inner tie rods last week, and my passenger side of the steering rack where the inner tie rod goes was leaking. I don't know how long. The fluid looks very old. So today we'll be doing a flush. I'll show you two ways you can do it. Show you how to do it. This works on any car. All right, little intro. All right, so like I said, if you follow the channel, last week I noticed I got a leak on my passenger side steering rack. I have no idea how long it's been there. The rack will probably be replaced sooner than later. It still drives fine, but we're gonna go ahead and replace the fluid. I'm gonna purge all the fluid using a synthetic ATF, and because I have a leak, and because I'm going to replace the rack in the near future, I'm gonna follow it up with some Prestone stop leak in the meantime. I'll take you to the car and show you two ways of doing it. There's one that's very similar to the Ranger method for clutch in the C5, if you're familiar. And the other one's a little more thorough that'll actually flush all the fluid out. So let's go to the car and I'll walk you through all the steps. It's not too hard. And you really should be doing this because, case in point, when you get too much debris and dirt in your power steering fluid, this is probably the stock fluid from the factory. You get too much friction on the seals, seals will break down, you get leaks. That's probably what happened with mine here. So you should probably do this every 5 years. Mine's probably hasn't been done in 22 years, so there it is. All right, so super easy to find. This is your power steering reservoir right here, right next to your throttle body, can't miss it. The tools you're gonna need to do this job is obviously replacement power steering. I have a unique situation. Like I said, I'll be flushing with this, but then using that. And then you're gonna need some sort of turkey baster or syringe. I use this pump. I put this down inside like that. I pump it out into this painter's can. It works just fine. And then we'll be reusing this painter's can too, or any kind of receptacle you can use, an old bottle or whatever. So we will be removing this return line right there momentarily. And to plug that though, we're gonna be using the tip of a latex glove with some rubber bands. I stole these from my daughter, so thank you. So first things first, we're gonna remove the cap and get all the fluid out of there. All right, so here's my crude setup. Like I said, I just plunger it into here. I got most of it out, much as I can. This stuff looks like coffee. It is disgusting. So I'm very glad I'm doing this. Now, to do the first method I'm talking about at this stage, once you get as much as you can sucked out of here, you would simply put in your replacement fluid up until where your little cap says it's full. And then you would drive it for a couple days, suck it out, replace it, suck it out, replace it. About 5 or 6 times, you'll get a decent amount of flushing going on. I would say 80 to 90% of the fluid will be replaced. But we're not going to stop there. What we're going to do now is take this little line off down there. We're gonna cap it off in the bottom. That's your return line. And then we're gonna cycle the steering wheel left and right to manually push the fluid through. And then we'll be adding fluid as necessary. So slow and steady is gonna win this race. Once we see the new fluid coming out of there, we know the system has been purged. And then at that point, I'll be adding my power steering stop leak. So yeah, let me go ahead and get this little guy off right there. And I'll show you exactly how I cap it. Not too crazy. Also, make sure you do this with the wheels off the ground. It'll make your life so much easier when you're doing the wheel left and right with no power steering aiding you, if that makes sense. You don't want to do this with the power steering pump running with the engine on. There's no way you could keep up with the fluid transfer. It'd get depleted in like 5 seconds. So that's why we do this manually. And that's why we use the steering wheel left and right, just lock to lock. Like I said, and we'll get this thing pretty flushed out. So let me go ahead and get this little clip off and I'll show you how I cap it. All right, here's my setup. That's my little cap for my return line plug, if you will, right there, rubber bands around it. And the return line, I have that going into a clear bottle, just kind of hanging out right there. That way I can see the fluid that will be coming out. So the next thing we gotta do is fill this up, your reservoir, with your desired fluid. Synthetic ATF mobile works. I've seen people put all kinds of different fluid in here. Anything that says power steering. I'll put what GM calls for right here on the screen, but it's a pretty simple system. I mean, I'm gonna go ahead and fill this up. If you got a steady hand, you can do it without a funnel. If you don't, use a funnel or make a mess. So let me get this thing filled up and we'll start going lock to lock on the steering wheel. All right, wheels are up. Return line going to the bottle, check. Fluid full, check. Not that exciting, just taking the wheel back and forth and we'll check our level. All right, so one all the way left, all the way right, got me about, that's 20 ounce bottle, 10 or so ounces. This thing's halfway down, so I'm gonna refill this. We're gonna do one more, put some more in there, watch the bottle, and we'll do it again. So I've done the wheel left to right, lock to lock, two full times. The bottle's about full, if you can see it there. We just refilled that guy, so I'm gonna dump the bottle, and then we're gonna go until that runs out, and then we'll start running the stop leak. All right, all together, I think I did about 7 total lock-to-lock wheel movements. I flushed the entire ATF through and to where I have a little bit left of the stop leak, but I'd say it's about 75% of the Prestone and 25% of the ATF. Regardless, all the old fluid has been flushed out. We will see how long this lasts. Like I said, I will be replacing the rack soon. More training for anyone that doesn't know how to do it. And again, this works on like 99% of cars. Hydraulic power steering is a very simple system. And again, this translates to most cars. So I'm gonna go ahead and get my return line back on there. I'll check my fluid level, put my cap back on, and we will go for a drive and make sure it doesn't blow up and we don't die or anything. So let me do that real quick. All right, well, she's all wrapped up. Takes about 25, 35 minutes, give or take. It actually felt better driving it. Might be placebo effect, I don't know, but it felt more crisp. Maybe, I don't know. But it's one of those boring kind of maintenance things. You gotta do a change in oil. It's not too exciting, but you gotta do it. Oh, and two things real quick. Don't let any of the power steering fluid touch your paint because it'll be a bad day and it'll eat through paint. It's very similar to brake fluid. And also, when you're doing it, don't let the reservoir run dry because it'll be more headache for you. You'll get air in the system and that's just a pain in the ass. Purging air out of any kind of system is just a pain. So just avoid that. Make sure you got enough fluid every time you're doing it. Not a hard job, just take your time. And again, just you can do the Ranger type method or you can do the way I showed you and flush the whole goddamn thing. So but this way, I feel a little better. This isn't the car, this is the C8. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed this and I will have a fun C5Z versus C8 comparison from a driver's perspective, living with just little things you wouldn't think about. That should be out, I'm thinking, next week, so be on the lookout for that. Well, that's all I got for today, boys and girls, and I'll catch you guys here in the near future. Mark out.